My name is S. Wesley Mallory. I go by Wes. I've been painting a long time. I'd been fishing a lot with my dad up in Canada, starting when I was about 10. And I really liked the weather in the sky out on the lake. I guess my attention just always kept going to the sky. And I think there's, to me, so much of an emotional content in the sky. It's almost like every kind of emotion you can imagine is there at some different time or another. I like dawn. I like the freshness, the beginning of day, and I like dusk. I like the edge of light, big sky. And I like clouds. I like dramatic quality to the sky. It can reflect your mood pretty amazingly. I've always been kind of drawn to sort of misty ambience, I guess, of things. And I have somewhat of a melancholy streak too. And the sky in the evening, as the sun is going, it just moves me a lot. So I've been painting that for quite a while. I paint to jazz music a lot, sometimes to classical music, depending on my mood. And the paintings kind of reflect that and regulates my speed, regulates my energy to some degree. Because I have an ability to sit outside and look at the sky and not be super motivated to do anything. But then if I put on music and I put a canvas up there and I'm looking at it and it's a fresh white canvas, I soon get into it, and often hours go by, and then when I'm exhausted, because when I'm through painting, it's the painting and I have said as much to each other as we possibly can. I like accident. I like things to surprise me. If I'm not surprised by the result of a painting when I'm through with it, if it hasn't gone someplace different than I might have visualized in the beginning, and so I don't have that goal of saying, boy, I'm gonna paint this and it's gonna look just like this when I'm done, because it never does. And if I really get past it, then it's taking me someplace that the initial impulse didn't do anything but just lead me into. I generally start with a particular palette, color palette. And sometimes I'll paint that painting to a position where there won't be enough surprise happening with it. Sometimes I set the painting down, I get aggravated with it. I set it in the corner and then I'll turn it around. And maybe I turn it upside down and by gosh, I see it a different way and I start fooling with it. That's what collaborating with the paint does. I mean, sometimes accidents happen on the canvas and you go, boy, that's free. You know, it's really unusual the way those two colors blended together that way. I think maybe I'm gonna run with that. My color has gotten more sophisticated and more. My palette has broadened greatly, and my gestural line has gotten away from real specifics sometimes. My brushes have gotten bigger too. I paint standing up. I move a lot around the studio when I'm painting. I approach the canvas. I step back and approach it, but the idea of it, that I'm meticulously working over something like that with a small brush, I want to swing my arms. I want to be more gestural and more open to impulse. When I'm painting, I get a spiritual lift out of it. And sometimes I need it. And I've actually tried to quit painting on a few occasions thinking, you know, these paintings are stacking up and, you know, I'm spending money on these materials, but I can't quit. doing it, because it's become so important to me emotionally that I couldn't stop doing it.